I've spent the last few talkthroughs making a grocery list. Well, now that I've realized how much eating I do, I realize what else I should be tracking in a database, how much exercise I'm doing. So I'll start by pasting in some statements that create a table and insert a few rows of data. Let's see what I have in exercise logs. We have an ID, of course, a type, which is a string like biking or dancing, minutes for how many I spent, calories for how many I burned, and heart rate for how high it went. Now, I'm inserting the data using a slightly different syntax than before. Notice how I'm specifying the column names in parentheses after the table name. When I do that, it means that I don't have to specify every column value here. I only have to specify the ones that I give in this list of column names. Now, do you see which one I didn't specify here? The missing column is ID, and that's very much on purpose. ID, here we go. The ID column is the primary key in the table, and it's set to auto increment. That means that the database will automatically fill it in for us when we tell it to, by picking an ID that's different from the other rows in the table, usually a number that's one bigger than the biggest number so far. Now, I would rather have the database figure that out than have me figure it out. So I usually like to do my inserts this way, leave out the ID, let the database do that work for me. Okay, so there we go. My database table is set up, and it looks like I've even done a bit of exercise. Go me! Let's find out where I'm burning the most calories with a simple query. I'll just modify this one. So select from exercise logs where calories greater than 50, and we'll just order by calories as well. Okay, so I've done two activities where I've burned more than 50 calories, and it looks like dancing burned the most. Now I want to find out which activities I've done that have burned more than 50 calories, but also taken less than 30 minutes, because I want to exercise more efficiently in the future. It's pretty obvious from looking at the current results. There's only two results. It's easy to look at that. But just imagine that there are thousands of rows. Maybe this is data from thousands of users. I would need a way to filter that down in the SQL query itself. To do that, I can use the AND operator to combine those multiple conditions, like to only return the rows where calories are greater than 50 and minutes are less than 30. Haha. So now I only see one result, dancing, which means I should just spend my whole life dancing, which sounds pretty good to me. Okay, so in a similar way, I could use the OR operator to return rows that meet any of some conditions. Like, let's say rows where calories are greater than 50 or heart rate is above 100. And that helps me find the most vigorous exercises. Now we can see that dancing and biking are both good. And actually, I do like biking. It's just a bit harder. Now, you can have as many OR and operators in your query as you'd like. The AND operator has precedence over the OR if you've got both of them in the same query, but you can always use parentheses to change the order of evaluation, just like with math expressions. Now I want you to try these out in the next challenge and stay tuned for the next talkthrough, where I'm going to show how to do some interesting things using this type column here. See you then.